Hello students, we have already done the classical evolutionary school. In this lecture, we will do the neo-evolutionary school of thought. Classical or unilinear evolutionists had to face rough criticism by 20th century diffusionists and relativists on the grounds of empirical data. Diffusionists emphasized upon the need of cultural diffusion, which brought about similarities in cultures of the world. They disfavored the idea of psychic unity and parallel intentions on the argument that basically men are uninventive, but they had limitless capacity to adapt and imitate, which is possible either by diffusion or by migration. In order to remove shortcomings of the earlier school of thought, neo-evolutionary scheme was proposed by neo-evolutionists. Among neo-evolutionists, Leslie White and Julian Steward were of the American school of thought, and Childe of Britain occupy a most significant place in reviving evolutionary theory. Neo-evolutionists believe that all weaknesses of classical evolutionary theory can be solved if it is accepted that culture develops not in unilinear sequence but in the form of parabolic curve. According to parabolic curve theory of cultural evolution, a social institution is born in a specific form in early stage. It then gradually develops in entirely different form and in different direction. It again moves towards original form but in a new developed form. For instance, the institution of property was born in the form of communal ownership or communism. In medieval times, the common ownership took the form of private ownership. Today again, the concept of common ownership through state has developed. As given in the flowchart below, for instance, the institution of property was born in the form of communal ownership or communism. In medieval time, the common ownership took the form of private ownership. Today, again, the concept of common ownership through the state has developed. Similarly, in the beginning, there was lack of clothes and men used to remain naked. Invention of clothes made it possible to cover the entire body. But in present times, the adoption of fashion is compelling to remain half naked. This sequence can also be observed in the field of sex relation. In early stage, there was sex promiscuity. In course of time, monogamy came into existence. And again, in the present time, arguments are made in favor of sex freedom. British neo-evolutionary school of thought. Childe, 1892 to 1957, he was the only pioneer of British school of neo-evolutionism. He was a great trained archaeologist. On the basis of collection of material remains from East and Europe and comparing them, he attempted to make evolutionary scheme alive. Some publications by him are The Dawn of Western Civilization in 1925, New Light on the Most Recent East in 1934, What Happened in History in 1946, Social Evolution in 1951, Man Makes Himself in 1951, What is History in 1953. His famous book, which describes evolution of culture, is Social Evolution. He described evolution of culture in terms of three major events: invention of food production, urbanization, and industrialization. Childe discussed evolution of culture of mankind as universal evolutionist because he had placed general stages of evolution applicable to mankind as a whole, not of specific or particular culture, which were the creation of local environmental factors. In establishing universal sequence of cultural development, he opined that all societies had lived in different historical environments and passed through different ups and downs, due to which their traditions had diverged and hence emerged cultural ethnography. He was of the opinion that establishing general stages of evolution, diffusion must also be discounted, because any society must be in a position to accept diffused technological and social features. Childe was of the view that at each stage of cultural development, mankind developed their technological skills to exploit natural resources. In early stage, less advanced technological skill had made them less aggressive towards environment. But as knowledge went on increasing, they became more and more aggressive. Criticism of Childe's scheme. He lacked interest in civilizational sequence outside of the Middle East and Europe. At one hand, he concluded on specific resemblance between the specific steps involved in the development of civilization in Europe, but he was unprepared to look for parallels in Mexico or Peru. He relied too much on archaeological data to explain cultural evolution. Also, he was unable to differentiate the old hunters and gatherers from today. He could not take into consideration the universal existing institutions of matriarchy, sexual promiscuity, etc., without giving any argument. Despite criticism, it was Childe who made alive the evolutionary theory even after serious criticism by 20th century revivalists. After having completed the Childe's view of neo-evolutionism, let us do some multiple choice questions on this topic. Question first, who of the following does not belong to the neo-evolutionist group? Option A, Leslie White. Option B, Julian Steward. Option C, E.B. Taylor. And option D, V.G. Childe. The correct answer for this question is option C, E.B. Taylor. Question number 2. Which of the following publication does not belong to V.G. Childe? Option A, The Dawn of Western Civilization. Option B, New Light on Most Ancient East. Option C, Social Evolution. And option D, None of These. The correct answer for this question is option D, None of These. All the others options are the publications of V.G. Childe. Question 3. Which of the following is not a major event in cultural evolution according to V.G. Childe? Option A, Invention of Food Production. Option B, Civilization. Option C, Urbanization. And option D, Industrialization. The correct answer for this question is Civilization, option B. With this, we come to an end to this lecture. We have learnt the Neo-evolutionary school of thought, the parabolic curve theory of cultural evolution. We learned the British school, V.G. Childe, universal evolution, and also the criticism of Childe's scheme. Thank you.